Hello students, in this video we will learn about shoot system. Shoot system, it consists of a stem. It lies above the ground and it consists of appendages like leaves, roots, flowers. The shoot system represents the aerial part of the plants. Aerial parts means the parts which expose to the air, like leaves, roots, stem. It consists of stem, branches, leaves and flowers. It develops from the plumule of the embryo. Plumule means the stem of an embryo plant. It develops. Next, stem. It is the main part of a plant. It grows against the gravitational force. So it is negative geotropic. Geotropic means the direction growth of an organism in response of light, where roots grow downwards to the soil. So it is positive geotropic, where stem grows upwards towards the soil. So it is negative geotropic. The stem grows towards light, so it is positively heliotropic. So the stem grows towards the sunlight, it is called positively heliotropic. Positive heliotropic means that the stem grows towards the direction of a sun. The stem has nodes and internodes. It bears buds and hairs. So the stem have nodes and internodes. It produces buds and hairs. Functions of stem. The stem conducts water and mineral salts from the roots to the leaves. The stem, it will conduct the water and mineral salts from the roots and it passes to the leaves. It transports the food materials from the leaves to other parts of the plants. It will transport the food materials from the leaves to other parts of a plant. The stem supports the branch and leaves. It gives support to a branches and a leaves. The green stems of the herbaceous plants manufacture food by photosynthesis. Herbaceous plants or vascular plants have no woody stem on an above ground. It has no woody stems. It will manufacture food by photosynthesis. The food prepared by a sunlight. So it is called photosynthesis. The stem of some plants store food materials. So the stem of some plants, it will store a food materials. The stem is two kinds. Namely, first one aerial stems, second one underground stems. First type, aerial stem. Aerial stem is found above the ground. It is found above the ground. The aerial stem is modified in many plants to perform a special functions. The stem is modified into many plants to perform a special functions like storage of food materials. There are seven types. First one, phylloclades, cladodes, stem tendrils, stem thorns, stem hooks, bulbils, pseudobulbs. First one, phylloclades. These are aerial stem modified like leaves for photosynthesis. It is modified into a leaves for photosynthesis. These are spines. It's modified leaves for the protection purpose. It is a flat fleshy stem called phylloclade. In photosynthetic, stems are known as phylloclades. The phylloclades consist of many internodes. It consists many internodes. Phylloclades are known in xerophytes. These are common in xerophytes. Xerophytic plants is a special type that adapted to survive environment with little water. Example, Opuntia and Xylophylla. In xerophytes, the leaves are reduced into scale leaves or spines to reduce the loss of water by transpiration. In xerophytes, the leaves are reduced into scale leaves. It's modified into scale leaves or spines because to reduce the loss of water by transpiration. Transpiration means it is the process of water movement through a plant and it's evaporated from a parts like leaves, stem, flowers. Hence the stem become green flat leaf like does photosynthesis. So the stem is green flat leaf like and it will do a photosynthesis. In Opuntia, the stem is flat, green fleshy and bears group of spines and modified leaves. In Opuntia, it will bears a group of spines and modified leaves. In Xylophylla, the phylloclades are ribbon-like. Here, the ribbon-like structures in Xylophylla. In Xylophylla, flowers develop along the margin of the phylloclades. Along the margin of a phylloclade, the flowers will develop. It is a phylloclade. Along the margin of a phylloclade, the flower will develop. Second type, cladodes. Cladodes or aerial stem consist of only one internode. Here, it consists only one internode. It modified for photosynthesis. So, it is modified for a photosynthesis. Example, asparagus, ruscus. Asparagus and ruscus belongs to the family Liliaceae. It belongs to family Liliaceae. In asparagus, the leaves are partially modified into scales. So the leaves are partially modified into scales and partially modified into spines. So in asparagus, it modified into scales and some modified into spines. The cladodes are green leaf-like and develops in groups at the nodes. So the cladodes are green leaf-like and develops in groups at the nodes. It develops at in a group at the nodes. In ruscus, the cladodes are leaf-like. It is leaf-like. They bear flowers in the axis of a bract. So, it bears flowers in the axis of a bract. Bract means modified leaf or scale, typically small of a flower in its axis. It is cladode. Along the cladode there is a flower and leaf morphed into a scale. Next step, stem tendrils. Stem tendrils are string like structure. It is a string like structure formed by the stem which helps in climbing. The tendrils are helps in climbing. Example, Caesar's quadrangularis, the terminal bird is morphed into tendril. So the terminal bird is morphed into a tendril. It helps in climbing. The tendril is at the apex first. First it is situated apex first, then it shifted to one side due to the growth of a stem. Here terminal bird morphed into a tendril in Caesar's quadrangularis. Next step, stem thorns. Stem thorns are stiff. Stiff means it doesn't bend. Pointed structures. It has a pointed structures which are produced by terminal or axillary buds of the stem. So the thorns, it will develop from the terminal or axillary buds of the stem, and they are meant for protection. For the protection, the thorns will develop. Example, Caresa, citrus, bougainvillea, etc. In Caresa, terminal bird morphed into thorns. So the bird is morphed into thorns. See, it is a thorn. It modified terminal bird. Next, stem hooks. Hooks or aerial stem modification. It is a aerial stem modification which helps in the plants to struggle on the support. The hooks, it will give support to the plant. Example, Bahinia arthrobotrys. In arthrobotrys, the inflorescence axis is modified into a strong hook. Inflorescence means arrangement of flowers in its axis. It modified into a strong hook. It helps the plant to struggle on the support. So the hook, it will give support to the plant. In Bahinia, the axillary bird is modified into hook. In Bahinia, the bird is modified into a hook. The hook is meant to climb on the support. It helps in climbing on the support. It is a hook modified axillary bird. Next, bulbils. Bulbils are the aerial stem modification. It is a bulb-like structure. It is aerial stem modification which are fleshy due to storage of food materials. It is fleshy due to storage of food materials and helps in vegetative propagation or reproduction. Vegetative propagation means if any part of a plant cuts, then the part will grow a new plant. Example, agave Dioscorea. Next, pseudobulbils. It is an oophytic outgrowth, sometimes replace ordinary sporangia like ferns due to production of Anthridia and their Archegonia. Oophytic means the sexual generation life cycle of archegoniate plants like ferns, mosses. At the stage, the sexual organs will develop like Archegonia and Anthridia. These are thickened, swollen internodes of the stem. So these are enlarged in internodes of the stem due to storage of food materials. Example, Bulbophyllum Cologen. Second kind of stem, underground stems. These are found below the surface of the soil. It found below the surface of a soil and called subterranean stems. So subterranean means the stems grow underground the soil. So it is called subterranean stems. The serves as store houses for reserve food. Due to storage of food material, this are called storehouses. Also helps in vegetative propagation. These are helps in vegetative propagations. Externally they resembles like roots. In external appearance they look like a roots, but the roots have no nodes and internodes, but the stem have nodes, internodes, buds and scaly leaves. Modification of underground stems. The underground stems are modified into special functions. So these are modified to do special functions. They are five kinds. First one, root stock, rhizome, comb, bulb, tuber. First one, root stock. Root stock is a vertical underground stem. It is vertical underground stem. It have nodes and internodes and terminal buds. So the underground stem have nodes, internodes and terminal buds, and it helps in vegetative propagation. Example, Launia and ferns. Next type, rhizome. The rhizomes is a horizontal fleshy underground stem. It is a horizontally will grow and fleshy underground stem. It have nodes, internodes, scaly leaves and axillary buds which are meant for storage. These will store up food materials and helps in vegetative propagation. Example, ginger and Canna indica, turmeric, etc. The terminal bud of the rhizome grows out of the soil. So the terminal bud of a rhizome, it will grows out of the soil and gives rise to a green shoot. It grows out of the soil and it will give a green shoots. At the end of season, the green aerial portion dries out. So at the end of season, the green aerial portion dies out. The further growth of rhizome is taken by the axillary bud. So the further growth of rhizome it takes by the axillary bud when the green aerial portion dies out. The rhizome is capable of living indefinitely. Indefinitely means unlimited. The rhizome is living unlimited inside the soil, giving rise to aerial green shoots. So the rhizome, it will give aerial green shoots and flowers during every favorable season. So in every favorable season, in every favorable reason, green shoots and flowers will gives the rhizome. The rhizome also stores food and serves food. It will store food and serves food. In ginger, it has scaly leaves and axillary bud and adventitious roots. In Canna indica, it is a rhizome, terminal bud and adventitious roots. In ginger, the rhizomes are much branched. The rhizome has many terminal buds. So in ginger, the rhizome has many terminal buds. Adventitious roots develop on the lower surface of the nodes. The roots will develop on the lower surface of the nodes of a ginger. Next to comb. Comb is a small and underground part of a stem. It is a round massive. Massive means a large or heavy. Swollen fleshy underground stem. It is a fleshy underground stem with nodes and internodes, scale leaves and terminal buds. So the comb have nodes, internodes, scale leaves and terminal buds and axillary buds, which are meant for storage of food materials. So these are help to storage of a food materials and vegetative propagation. Example, Amorphophallus, Colocasia, Colocus, etc. The comb is a massive underground stem. It is a heavy underground stem with very big terminal bud. It has a very big terminal bud. The comb is attached to the soil by numerous adventitious roots. So it is attached to the soil by a numerous adventitious roots. The roots are attached to the comb. In Colocus, the comb has special roots known as contractal roots. So the comb has a special roots known as contractal roots. The main function of contractal root is the change of growth of a cortex in parenchyma. In addition to the normal roots, the contractile roots also develop in the comb. It is a terminal bud, axillary bud and adventitious roots. It will grow underground of the soil. Next type, bulb. The bulb is a reduced underground stem. It is a reduced underground stem. It consists of nodes, terminal bud, axillary buds, fleshy, scaly leaves and adventitious roots. These are helps to a store of food materials and vegetative propagation. Example, Allium sepa is nothing but onion and Allium sativum is nothing but a garlic. Bulbs are two types, tunicated bulb and scaly bulb. First one, tunicated bulb. In tunicated bulb, the fleshy scaly leaves overlap one another. So the scale leaves overlap one another and arrange in a concentric circle. So the leaves are arranged in a concentric circle. Example, Allium sepa is nothing but an onion. See, these are adventitious roots. It present underground the soil. These are axillary buds, scale axillary buds. Next is scaly bulb. In scaly bulb, the fleshy scale leaves are arranged loosely. Here, the leaves are arranged loosely and do not form a concentric circles. Here, it doesn't form a concentric circles. Example, Allium sativum. In bulbs, the stem is highly reduced. It will reduce and scale leaves are fleshy and meant for storage. So the leaves are fleshy and it helps to storage of food materials and adventitious roots arise from the base of the reduced stem. So the roots are arranged from a base of a reduced stem. During favorable season, the terminal buds grows and produce the peduncle of inflorescence has scape. The scape bears flowers. Peduncle means a stalk of inflorescence. Inflorescence means arrangement of a flowers. Scape bears flowers. Scape means a long flower. It comes directly from the roots. Next step, tuber. Stem tubers or underground stems. These are underground stems. It formed from the branches of aerial stems and mean for a storage of food materials and vegetative propagation. It is helps to a storage of food materials and vegetative propagation. Example, Solanum tuberosum is nothing but a potato. So these are adventitious roots and it is a tubers. In potato, some of the branches at the base of the aerial stem become positively geotropic. In potato, some branch at the base of aerial stem, it becomes positively geotropic and grows into the soil. Negative geotropic means the stem which grows upwards over the soil. But here positively geotropic means grows into the soil. They develop tubers at the terminal end inside the soil. So this develops a tuber at the terminal end inside the soil. The tubers are fleshy. It are fleshy and bears number of pits on the surface called eyes. So it bears a number of pits on the surface. It called eyes and each eye has a scale leaf and three dormant buds. So each eye has a scale leaf and three dormant buds. These buds give rise to aerial shoots. means a large holes. So the tubers, it bears a number of large holes called eyes, and each eye has a scale leaf and three dormant buds, and these buds give rise to aerial shoots. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe.